Hi, and welcome to the TIC Gums virtual booth here at the IFT. My name is Harold Nickel. I'm joined by the gum guru, Maureen Akins. And today, we're going to be talking about emulsions, texture, and stability. Texture and stability, let's take those apart separately, and let's start with texture. It's an important part of the sensory experience of any kind of food, but in terms of these types of food products, what are we talking about when we mean texture?
Well, texture certainly is your personal interpretation of what that product does in your mouth, and then ultimately what it tastes like as you swallow it. But we want to make sure that your experience as you look at the product, when you first put it in your mouth, and then as you swallow that product, actually performs exactly as you would anticipate or has a wow factor for you.
So when we take something away, and let's talk about fat.
Sure.
If we remove fat, what is the impact of that removal on these kinds of products?
So the way fat works is that it has this wonderful sensation of actually keeping those flavors in your mouth for a long time. So it has a very slow release or dissolution in the mouth. If you remove that, you tend to get very fast rate of dissolution, which means your flavor actually dissipates more quickly and you get the sense of a hollow feeling, not quite full. And really with hydrocolloids, you are able to replace a portion, if not all of that loss.
Okay, so you mentioned stability, so let's shift gears into that space. How do hydrocolloids help us manage stability?
Right, so in the examples that we have here in front of us, this is a simple emulsion demonstration, but there's a couple of ways that you're going to actually stabilize a product like a salad dressing like we have here. And first and foremost is you're gonna make it thick. Salad dressings are beautifully thick. They cling beautifully to the surface of lettuce because we have a lot of apparent viscosity in here. When you have something that contains a large portion of oil, you also have to be considered about the effects on emulsification. So in that instance, included in that umbrella of stability comes the ability of hydrocolloids to emulsify.
So in these examples that we have here, we're showing how hydrocolloids are keeping water and oil together?
That's right. So whenever you have something that is a true emulsifier or something that has, they call them amphiphilic molecules, something that contains both a water-loving portion and a fat-loving portion to the same molecule, you essentially create a condition where that molecule can hold hands with the oil and water and keep them together. With the introduction of an emulsifier, you're able to do that. But it's all about the process, making sure that you have sufficient shear to create that emulsion in the first place. And then the emulsifier will actually help to stabilize that.
Okay, Maureen, so we've talked about texture and we've talked about stability and what happens when we remove fat from sauces and dressings. So now we have a fat-free honey mustard dipping sauce that we served at the IFT stand. Tell us about the role of hydrocolloids in this particular formulation.
So in this instance, we modeled it after a full fat dressing, about 35% oil. And this one actually, so we had a few challenges to check right off the bat. First, we had to replace all that viscosity. So think, here's our stabilization portion. And we did that using a very specific set of ingredients. Second set, we had to make sure that we paid attention to all of those mouthfeel characteristics that we lost using when we removed the fat. So we had to look at a separate set of hydrocolloid ingredients. And it's really the combination of all of those things together that gives you the closest product that you can have to something that was full fat to begin with.
So this is very good. If you want to learn more about this, I suggest that you visit our website, chat with a guru, or talk to him on the telephone. You can also download more technical information, lots of things to know about in this very, very complex field. I want to thank Maureen Akins for being with me and for her expertise. Come to our website as often as you can. We're constantly adding content there. Thanks for being with us today.